Hello friends, how are you? So fine. Today we are going to see the next topic, that is antiarrhythmic agents. The learning outcome for this, on completion of these sessions, there are total 4 sessions, you will be able to define and describe the arrhythmia. You can differentiate the different types of arrhythmia and their pathophysiological consequences. Then you can classify the different antiarrhythmic agent and you will be determining the strategy behind this treatment of arrhythmia. Then you can predict the pharmacotherapy for arrhythmia as well as you can explain the mechanism of various antiarrhythmic agents. Now here I am just playing a small game with you. Here there are 2 songs I am having. One is Bhakti Geet and another is a romantic song. So to explain what is a rhythm, first of all we will listen to these songs.
देवाचिये द्वारी उभा क्षण भरी देवाचिये द्वारी उभा क्षण भरी तेडे मुक्ति चारी.
So I will pause this song and I will play a second song for you. Now you have listened to this both the songs. First song is Bhakti Geet, which is having a very rhythmic tabla and the song, and in second song there is a rhythmic guitar. So individually if you listen to these songs, they are very beautiful. But now both the songs are very beautiful. Now what the actual experiment start over here. Now I will play these songs again. Now when I played both the song at a time, neither you can enjoy the Bhakti Geet nor you can enjoy the romantic songs. So this is what happened with the a perfect rhythm converted to arrhythmia. There is no rhythm at all in both the songs. So this is what happens in our heart also. The parameters are perfectly all right, but whenever the overall working of the heart, if you see, there is a complete mesh of it. So this same concept I am again going to explain you with the help of some diagrams over here. So suppose this is one cycle, which is some event, just bar we have. I have not drawn any kind of a graph like PQRST in like that way, or 0, 1, 2, 3 phase, 4 phases inside the electrophysiology or ECG. So these are the bar. One line represents some one event which is taken place inside the heart. So this is a perfect heart now. And if you see, you can say that this is a perfectly rhythm. So each and every event is taking place as a particular position. Now, if you go for the second part, again, we can say this is a little bit longer, but again there is having a perfect differentiation and every event is taking place again in a perfect direction. So again, if you can say second event is also rhythmic, but if you mix together this both, then what will happen? So this is a perfect rhythm. So total, in total together, the first event and second event combined together to become a arrhythmia. So this is what happening inside the heart. So how it is happening, we will see. So whenever this arrhythmia occurs, so there are two things which is happen. You are knowing, whenever there is a normal pacemaking activity inside the heart, there are AC nodes which generate the impulse, then AV node, bundle of Hayes and Purkinje Fabre, they conduct the impulse further and they transmit the impulse. So there are two events which are taking place in a conducting system of the heart: impulse generation and impulse conduction. So whenever the arrhythmia occurs, either two things happens. There is an abnormality in the impulse generation or abnormality into the impulse conduction. So generated impulse is abnormal or conducted impulse is abnormal. So impulse generation, that is ectopic pacemaker activity, due to that the impulse generation is disturbed. There's an alteration in the automaticity. The SA node is having automaticity, so that automaticity is altered, or there is an abnormality in automaticity, or there is a triggering into the automaticity. So due to that there is an formation of ectopic pacemaker. Ectopic pacemaker means a different kind of a cells which are generating the impulse. They themselves are also rhythmic, but along with the SA node they becomes totally arrhythmic then. So abnormal impulse conduction, then it will also have a different types again. Heterogeneity in electrophysiology, you are knowing electrophysiology is having a perfectly phases over there, 0, 1, 2, 3, and they are repeatedly, they are just like a normal, but something abnormality, there is a heterogeneity in one and second part of the electrophysiology. There will be slow conduction, unidirectional block, and circuit reentry. By the figures I will explain this to you. Now this is what the impulse generation, disturbance in the impulse generation. You can see here there is a perfect generation of impulse from SA node, and this is a perfectly abnormal heart working of the heart. The impulse will be transferred from one place to the other. Now here there is another heart where there is a generation of the impulse is disturbed. You can see here there is ectopic cells are there, and due to these ectopic cells there is a disturbance in the impulse generation. This impulse generation will have the altered in the automaticity, that is SA node, AV node, Purkinje fiber, and due to that there is an abnormality into the automaticity, enhanced automaticity you can spoil out, or beta adrenergic stimulation, adrenergic stimulation activity. Due to that this SA node will start firing the impulse and they will generate the unnecessary impulse which is not coinciding with the SA node, and therefore they are becoming the arrhythmic. Hypokalemia, mechanical stress, increased force, phase 4 sleep, these are the some reasons. Then abnormal automaticity, excessive intracellular calcium, digitalis toxicity, catecholamines, these can be a few reasons behind the impulse disturbance into impulse generation. Triggered activity, in that abnormal depolarization and toxicity due to the drugs, these are also some reasons behind the automaticity occurrence of the ectopic cells. Now there is a disturbance in impulse conduction, that is a transfer of impulse has been disturbed over here. So different types of impulse generations we are knowing. So in heart, what basically what happens over here is that some fibers are there, proximal fibers and distal fibers, if you see, and if you deciding it's two pathways, that alpha pathway and beta pathway, these are just norms, names we have given over here. So alpha pathway means one pathway, this is second pathway. So this is what the normal conduction which is happening inside the our heart. Now due to some pathophysiological consequences, there are something happen into the one of the pathway over here. So there might be some ischemia or some damage or some infection which has taken place. Due to that, this part has become a somewhat damaged, and the conduction to this path is little bit slower. So this path conducts the impulse little bit slow, and due to that what happens, this is the slow conduction type of impulse conduction. So one impulse will come from this proximal side, and whenever it is going, the first impulse will go normally over here, and the second impulse which is going through this damaged path will go as a second. So there is a velocity between these two impulse will not match. You can see the normal both the they are coming and they are going as a one, but here one will go and second will follow it, or it will go back again. So this is happen whenever there is a slow impulse conduction. Now in the third type there is a block, unidirectional block, means here there is a slowing of the signal, here there is a blocking of the signal, there is a complete damage to that nerve, and due to that damage what will happen, the nerve impulse will come as one over here, one will go by the alpha pathway and second will bounce back from here, which is not propagated through the beta pathway, and it will come back. But whenever it will come back till the normal pathway alpha already has gone ahead, the second will come and it will behave as a second impulse. So whenever from the proximal side it is only one signal is coming, one is going as a normal, the second which is going into the beta, it will come back, it will bounce back this through from this block and it will come like this way. Again it will bounce here and it will be divided and again come in. So one signal which is coming over here will become a 2 to 3 signals over here. So this is happening in a unidirectional block. And the third thing which is happening is the circuit re-entry. Now this block which is over here or the damage which is over here, it occurs at this point or at this point also. So what happens, that signal will come, okay, it will divide into alpha pathway and beta pathway and it will not propagate further. So the one which is coming from alpha pathway will go into the beta pathway and one which is coming from beta pathway is going to the alpha pathway like this. And what will happen, there is a circulation of this impulse will take place and the circuit will form over there and the impulse will go on round and round. Re-entry of that impulse will take place, unnecessary twitching of that impulse will take place. So the signal will travel in one loop of circle over there. This is what the circle re-entry. So this is what happens whenever there is a conduction, the abnormality into the conduction of impulse, the slow conduction, then unidirectional block or circuit re-entry. So this is happens whenever there is an pathophysiology of the arrhythmia takes place. So in the next parts we will continue. So thank you very much. Thank you.